Hi, my name is Chelsea Anderson, and I am a veterinarian. I grew up in Connecticut, spent a lot of time on the water and in the woods with my dad, and developed an early fascination for science and animals. My grandfather was also a radiologist, and I used to love to go to work with him, was completely hypnotized by the x-rays. They were so cool. I went to veterinary school at Cornell in upstate New York and graduated 6 years ago. I've always sort of had an untraditional path in my veterinary career. It started in vet school. I spent my first summer living in Uganda, working with a local veterinarian, and just had my mind completely opened to what was possible. I then went to Indonesia the following summer and studied anthrax and how it related to the deaths of local rhinoceros. I also taught a course with one of my professors in West Africa, teaching poultry production in Liberia, and that was eye-opening as well because that nation basically imports all their food and has no sustainable agriculture. I dreamt of being able to do field work and travel and save animals. I mean, who doesn't? I still do. But reality kicked in and I realized that I needed to seriously consider where I was going to get mentorship, how I was going to pay my loans, and, you know, have some quality of life. So I moved home and I lived at home for 3 years and worked in an amazing small animal practice, learned a ton, got really good skill set, and then decided it was time to leave home and move to New York City. And worked in a top-notch, high-end boutique practice on the Upper East Side and basically catered to the super wealthy, you know, preventative care to a fault sometimes. Saw Yorkies come in their $2,000 carriers and people dropping off fecal samples in their Hermes shopping bags with sprigs of rosemary in them. And it was wild. But I learned so much medical and surgically. It was amazing. But then I decided something was missing. I loved volunteering. I loved giving my skills to others, teaching them, giving my time, and basically helping those who needed me more. And so I took what was supposed to be a 10-month sabbatical, and I traveled to the Cook Islands, Papua New Guinea, Sri Lanka, and India. India was the poorest and the toughest. Those animals have no quality of life and there's nobody to care for them. They are often starving and disease riddled. It was challenging. Sri Lanka had its own challenges. They are Buddhist and they don't believe in euthanasia, so that's not an option. And I saw miraculous cases that would never have been given a chance in the United States and learned a ton. And now I'm working and doing relief work in Montana, where I had hoped to move at the end of the summer, in order to be able to create my own schedule and also volunteer. But I'd be lying if I said that finances weren't a huge stress most of the time. The veterinary profession, you know, we graduate with as many loans as our medical counterparts, but with about 30 to 40% of the earning potential. So, you know, we're strapped with loans and it is debilitating sometimes. And in spite of living at home and, you know, paying down chunks of my loans, there's a compromise there. You know, we don't save, we can't buy the house right away, and it doesn't give us the flexibility to really not work for periods, to volunteer. I would love to set up a nonprofit that normalizes this for American veterinarians and gives them the opportunity to volunteer for a couple of weeks during the year. It feels great. It is gratifying. And we are in a profession that unfortunately has a high incidents of suicide. A lot of that is people being unhappy in their jobs. So I would love to make that possible. I love teaching. You know, I'm really inspired when I see people learn the skills and then do them themselves. I love educating clients. I love making that plan that feels right for them within their budget and teaching them about how to best care for their pets. You know, to me, being a veterinarian is being the advocate for that animal and making sure that the clients know what they're doing. And I love that about it. I really am inspired by this whole common thread of humanity and us all living amongst each other, and I really want to continue that. Fun stuff now. My go-to pump-up song is Anything by Avicii. I take my coffee black. I obviously love to travel. And I started a Sunday summit series this summer in Montana, where every Sunday I would hike to the top of a mountain, and it was really gratifying, especially during the pandemic. The best advice I've received is to take every opportunity that you're given. Even if you don't know how it's going to work out or it seems impossible at the time, you will not regret it. That has been a common theme for me. Make the connections, build friendships, work hard, enjoy the small moments, and create that web of humanity that represents life.